We're going to start off with our fiddler, Larry Ellis, the Big Creek Band, and this is a song called Avalanche.
I've had many people come in and visit people, and they'll bring them to the show. So you got to see this show, you know, you won't believe it. Here in the small town, you know, it's like a Branson show, like a professional show. If they're back in town again, the same bunch will come to the show again. They say, oh, we got to go to Big Creek. You know, that was one of the highlights of our trip. I'm the owner and I MC the show and I play sax and piano once in a while. The theater was built in 1909, so it's 110 years old. It became a movie theater in the 50s. And then after they were here till 1981, we bought the theater when we heard about it being for sale. They were getting older and needed to retire from everything. So we took the theater over in 82, and opening night, we had 450 people here.
So Dennis auditioned me years ago and said he was opening up a country show. And at first I thought, oh boy, I wonder if this guy is legit. Sure enough, he was. He had the building and they were putting in seating and building the stage. And we opened up 37 years ago on a Halloween night and was a full house, and from there is the story.
There's something special and charming about this little theater, the history of it. The silver screen still hangs behind our back curtain, so we really have tried hard to preserve the history of it. But there's just a lot of charm to this little theater. It just feels very much like home to us.
The theme is pretty much the same. I think the musicianship has improved. The guests get better and better all the time. Can't believe some of the really young men and women that really seem to know classic country music.
What do you think you run into? Hey, pass me by if you're only passing through.
The songs have stories of personal meanings to the people that wrote them and sang them. And they transmit that. There's nothing like music that transmits a feeling from one person to another.
I love the music here, and old country music is like, some people, you've heard the saying, you can't beat a classic. In this case, it's quite true.
The people that really enjoy our music are probably 40s on up. I have one lady that's been with me here for 25 years probably. She's 103 years old.
What do you like about the show?
Well, I like Aaron's part.
A lot of people have become like, it's like a big family down here. You know, they all know each other. They can't wait till the next Saturday so they can get together and talk about what they've done during the week.
Most of us were in our teens or early 20s when we started doing this show together. And we've grown up together on the stage, sharing our passion. So we are deeply connected to each other because we, you know, what we love to do the most, we share that. And we not only feel that kinship with each other, but with many of the people who come here, who've come and watched us week after week, year after year.
There's no place like home. And, you know, when you have friends like this, they're lifetime friends. And one of the neat things about friends like this is that when you want to go try something else a little different, you know, and kind of spread your wings a little bit, they're very supportive and they say, well, we'll see you when you get back. And that's why I always want to come back.
You know, so we've all worked physically hard at making this happen as well. A lot of blood, sweat, and tears. A lot of heart, a lot of passion has gone into it. And I think that's what has made it more special is because of our hard work, we all own a piece of it, you know, and we feel that ownership and that devotion and responsibility to our audiences to give them our very, very best.
Good night.